In 2 weeks, I have some former students and a friend coming over for a Regimental Fire and Fury game. And I'm excited. It's going to be in 2 weeks, but I've got vacation and stuff coming up, so I needed to get it set up early. And so this is my table, and I'm really pleased with it. The scenario is taken from this book. There's a series of these. This one is on Gettysburg. And so I wanted a smaller game. And so this is the first day of Gettysburg. And this scenario is Heath renews the attack. And so he's driven off Buford's cavalry, and now he is making a second push up onto McPherson Ridge. So over here from Rhodes' division, he has Daniel's brigade. And Daniel's brigade is made up of basically green troops. At the top of the hill, Baxter has been driven back, and then they're supported by, I think, the 4th U.S. Battery of Artillery. And then over here, we have Dana. And Dana's men are all green troops, and he's a poor commander, so he's the center of the line. There's an orchard there. I believe that's the Chambersburg Pike, which is going to be very prominent in later days. The best Confederate troops are Broken Braw's brigade, and these are all Heath's. The next two brigades are Heath's men. So these are crack and vet troops. And then on the right flank is Pettigrew's brigade of North Carolinians. And they're huge. This is 21 stands. This one is 15, and then 14, and 14. But they're all basically green troops as well. On the Union left flank, that's Biddle's brigade with Pennsylvanians, and they've got a New York battery supporting them. And then here in the middle is the Iron Brigade, Meredith's brigade, and they're very good troops. They have one additional regiment there back in the trees that's trained, so they're not up to par, but they're going to kind of be a reserve. So the objective is basically for the Union to hold, but to inflict as many casualties as they can on the Confederates. The Confederates have Pegram's battalion of artillery, so they've got three batteries here, so that's six stands, and then they've got two more batteries down here. So they have a total of 10 stands of artillery. The Union only has six, so that's an advantage. They also have more infantry. The Confederates have more infantry, but they're not very good. So they're going to wear down pretty quickly. And you can see that they get some obstacles. That's Plum Run there, the stream. It was pretty wooded where the Iron Brigade was. There's cornfield here, other fields, and then the nice thing about this new table mat that I have is I can put the terrain under it. So I don't know if you can tell from the camera angle, but it does rise up. So should be a lot of fun. The guys that are coming are just tremendous young men, all at university now. So here's the Union position, Baxter's men along the fence here. The corkboard there, that's the railroad cut that goes down. There's Dana's men. I'm not sure the name of that farm, but it's a farm that was part of the battle. And coming up behind, there's the Union brigade. And then this is the top of, this is McPherson Ridge. So there's Battery EL of the 1st New York, their limbers. And then these are Biddle's men. And I've got two units of Zouaves just to add some color to it. These guys are mostly trained with some veterans. So really looking forward to the game. I will certainly post a report when it's all said and done. But love these rules. I love the fact that I can create anything. And I like the stands. It's like one stand equals 40 troops. So it's lots of figures and should be a great game. So anyway, thanks for watching. And I'll post a report in a couple weeks. Take care. Enjoy your wargaming hobby.